Andrew, thank you very much indeed. I'm delighted to be here this evening at the F1 in Schools Championships. Share the venue tonight with a young man that I know you've heard a lot about. When Lewis Hamilton was 16, Michael Schumacher said that he was a fantastic driver and said if he keeps this up, he will be in Formula One. And 6 years later, he became the youngest person ever to win the F1 World Championships. Well, he's a nice guy as well, isn't he? You know, that's the first time I've met him, but it's nice when somebody achieves and turns out to be, you know, a nice guy as well. All of you have taken part in a similar World Championship, showcasing your own skills for engineering and designing the cars that people like Lewis will one day drive. If you keep that up by learning about science and technology at school or college, then you can go on to achieve great things. Because there hasn't been a more exciting time to learn about science and technology than today. Our scientists and technicians are the people that shape the world around us. From combating climate change to the design of record-breaking fast cars. But as technology continues to stride forward, so must we. Recent reports have said that there will be 3 million more science, maths and technology related jobs in Britain in less than 10 years' time, and millions more across the world. So it's becoming more and more important that more young people are like you, engaged by science, technology, engineering and maths, so that when they leave education, they can function in a world where a career in science and technology is the norm. And Andrew mentioned to me, and Andrew, congratulations again to everything that you've done to make all of this possible here tonight. But Andrew mentioned to me, and I think it is something worth saying this and highlighting, that when we talk about young people here tonight, we don't only talk about young men, we talk about young women as well. And I think that is an important statement that we're making here tonight as well. Here in the UK, we have been encouraging more students to be interested in these subjects. We recently launched what we call the STEM Club Network, where 500 after-school science and maths clubs across the country can get new ideas for group projects, and where other schools can start up their own STEM clubs. And I know that there are many other initiatives like that in other parts of the world as well. And as the Minister of State for Schools, I am always interested in ways of making learning more engaging and immediately relevant for our students, giving them a passion for learning that will last them throughout their education and indeed after. F1 in Schools Championships are an excellent way of getting young people excited about jobs in science and technology. Not only does it teach specialist skills like how to design a car and construct working gas-powered models, but it also shows the values of good teamwork, planning and preparation, and how working with different technology can aid your studies, the cornerstones of so many professions. And the championships also offer a unique opportunity to learn from international competition about different methods and approaches you can take when you set a task. And can I just say as well, that when you come to an event like this, we're all inspired, and Andrew mentioned it, but we're all inspired by the exhibitions that we see, set up in this hall by young people from around the world. And often, and let me just make one last point, often our young people get a bit of a raw deal. They get a bit of, you know, they're all somehow committing crime and not what they should be. I think what we see here tonight is the real truth about young people, demonstrated in the exhibitions that we see around this hall. Vibrant young people, excited by the future, determined to do well for themselves, their families and their communities. And I think when you see that, it inspires us for the future and gives us great hope indeed for the future. So congratulations to everyone who has taken part. I hope you found your time in the championships enjoyable as well as informative, and it's a great privilege for me to have been asked to come here tonight. Thank you very much indeed.
Well, I would just echo the words of the Minister there. I mean, I've been a proud patron of F1 in schools for, what, 6 years, is it, Andrew? And I'm just inspired by everything that you can do for young children, giving them a goal, and it's amazing. Every year I come back and I see better and better standards. It's absolutely fantastic. But let's get on with the awards. And I should just mention that this evening's presentation is being webcast live around the world. So families in Malaysia and China and Australia are following this live. So let's have a big hello to everyone around the world. Hello from London, and we're going to get on to the awards now. The first award is for the best newcomer, and I'd like to invite Tim Biles from the Transformation Trust to come up to the stage, please. The Transformation Trust is a brand new charity set up by Partnership for Schools, launched to fund activities from drama to F1 in schools. And the Transformation Trust is planning to raise £20 million in the next 5 years to help F1 in schools reach more children across the country. So, the winner of the first award, the best newcomer, the judges said, competing for the first time with the highest points score, they've only been involved for less than a year. The judges very much liked Blue Force from the Czech Republic. The natty outfits. Blue Force, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much indeed. Right, straight on to the second one. Delighted to present up on to welcome up on stage another patron of F1 in schools, one of the smartest engineers in Formula One, the technical director of the Williams Formula One team. Please welcome Sam Michael. This is best verbal presentation. The judges said that this team delivered a clear, well-structured and coherent presentation. They are the Coney Cats from Ireland. Impressive presentation from the Coney Cats. I got it myself, actually. I went to visit them and I got the full Irish blarney. Well done, Coney Cats. And thank you, Sam. Okay, straight on to the best portfolio. I'd like to invite up onto stage the commercial director of the world's best-selling Formula One magazine, F1 Racing, Mr. Ian Burrows, please. So, best portfolio, good evening, Ian. Best portfolio, the judges said this was professionally presented with impact and excellent team identity throughout. The winner of the best portfolio award is the collaboration from Australia and Canada, AC Racing.